Hello students, the topic of today's class is Gutmann scale or scalogram and also known as cumulative scale. This class is for the fourth semester students of BA Arts in Psychology. Now let us look at what is Gutmann scale. The name Gutmann came from its founder Louis Gutmann. He was a social scientist and in 20th century he developed this scale. It is a scale to measure the attitude of the respondents, that is positive or negative attitude. They have to agree between two responses, that is yes or no, or agree or disagree. It is one of the three unidimensional scales. The other two scales are Likert scale and Thurston scale. What is the meaning of unidimensional? That means they have to answer only yes or no. The answer is just one, which is said to be uni. They have to mark yes or no. What is the Gutmann scale actually? It is a list of statements or a list of questions, we can say. And from the beginning to the end, they just have to read the sentence and they have to answer. They have to tick either yes or no, or agree or disagree. And each statement will have a value, which is also called corresponding weight. Okay, it is one. If they say yes, it is one. And if they say no, it is zero. And in a five scale, Gutmann scale, suppose that they say yes, they have ticked yes three times and they have ticked no two times, then the scoring will be three. That means they have agreed to three statements on the cumulative scale. Now let us look at the characteristics. It is firstly said to be unidimensional in nature. The statements or the questions are arranged from the least difficult one to the most difficult one. Say for instance, in a 10 item scale, if the respondents scores 8 and his answers are 8 yes and 2 no, it means that the first 8 items of the scale are agreed upon by the respondent and the respondent disagrees with the last two statements of the scale. Secondly, it is deterministic in the sense that we can easily find out the person's attitude by the responses. If there are 50 questions and the person scores, suppose about more than 50%, more than 25%, we can say that the person's attitude is a bit favorable on the topic. Suppose it is a questionnaire on positive mental health and the statements are all regarding positive mental health. So if the person scores about 40 out of 50 or more than 40 out of, we can easily determine that the person's mental health is positive. So this is how the scalogram looks like. These are the people A, B, C, D, E. And these are the items or the questions. Suppose A answers all the questions as yes, agrees to all the questions, will get 4. B agrees to 3 questions, disagrees to 1, it will be 3. And C says yes twice, gets 2. And D says yes once and gets a score of 1. And E disagrees to all the statements and hence the score is 0. The third characteristics of Gutman scale is reproducible questions are added. This means that the questions which produce desired results will only be retained. At first, when the researcher tries to construct a Gutman scale, number of questions or a lot of items will be recorded down or noted down, and those questions which will produce the results will only be retained, and the others which are seem to be irrelevant will be eliminated. Then fourthly, the ordinal nature, that means from 1, 2, 3, 4, in that way the items are numbered from the items which are of minimum importance to the items which has maximum importance. Now this is an example. At first, this is the first step, that the statements are being noted down, are being written. For example, this is a scale, this is a Gutman scale on depression. Four items are shown here, only four items. The standardized test, they will give the details of the scoring and everything, but this is the first step. Like when the person begins to develop a Gutman scale, at first the person, or the researcher has to write down the statements, and there are two responses, yes and no. Now let us look at how to create a Gutman scale. The first step would be to define the topic of your research. That means what topic we will choose. Is it positive mental health? Is it about the attitude of students towards online teaching? Attitude of students towards this lockdown? Things like that. So the topic of the research should be selected first. Then related to the topic, number of items has to be noted down, or we can also say the questions. Then we have to put the scores of the question. If there are 50 questions, that means 50. The total score will be 50. Then we have to order the questions from the least to the most supportive, from the least important to the most important question, or the least difficult question, very easy question, to the most difficult question. Now we arrive at the advantages of Gutman scale. Now Gutman scale, the first advantage is that it is very easy to answer the questions in a very limited time. Less amount of time is required. It is easy to understand, and in a short amount of space, we can accommodate many items or questions. It is very appealing to the people. Why? Because it is very easy to answer. They have to choose only between yes or no. And it provides ranked data. That is, it follows the nominal scale of arranging the items. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then reproducibility, I have already explained in the previous slide, and as already we have come to know that it is a unidimensional scale, just like the Likert scale. The first difficulty associated with Gutman scale is that it is not easy to construct a Gutman scale, and very perfect Gutman scale are also not available for use, and the statements that are being constructed, they may not have the same meaning, they may not mean the same for the respondents and the judges who are actually judging the statements and who are finding the whether the scale is being constructed properly or not. So the in that case, the scale will not be able to measure what it is supposed to measure, and they are said to be very, very rigid and restrictive, and analysis is quite difficult in comparison to other scaling techniques, and it is said to be not very reliable for predicting the behavioral responsible I mean responses of the individuals. Thank you.